Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Devil in the White City: Murder, Magic and Madness at the Fair That Changed America, book by Eric Larson. The construction of the buildings for the fair was also intriguing, though a bit disturbing. Homes in order to expose how desires can provoke actions which lead to the creation and destruction of humanity. H. Holmes, who is believed to be responsible for scores of murders around the time of the fair. He devised and erected the World's Fair Hotel, complete with crematorium and gas chamber near the fairgrounds, and used the event as well as his own charismatic personality to lure victims. With Devil, Larson tells the tale of how Chicago was selected to host the 1893 World's Fair, but also interweaves the tale of Dr. Larson mixes in the individuals who made the World's Fair happen, how it came to be, and the spectacle, doing so with such lively and engaging prose you'd wish you could go back in time to have seen it. Holmes saw the opportunity to prey on unsuspecting young women who came to Chicago to see the fair. Along the way, Holmes sets up dubious businesses and eventually creates a hotel that becomes his custom-built slaughterhouse, a virtual house of horrors designed to foster his slaughter in a most efficient and diabolical manner. But not everything goes so smoothly, and with all the problems encountered, it's truly astonishing the fair ever happened or that it made any money. Also fascinating was the storyline of the determined detective Frank Geyer, who doggedly pursued Holmes's path to find his victims. In the end, Devil is a glimpse into that society and the culture of that era in a way you almost never get in narrative histories. The fact that Chicago had not only become a world-class city but also one rife with opportunity for the most vile of criminals is really interesting to behold. How there were no real strikes during the construction and the hard work and toil of all the people certainly make this book worth reading for that reason only. Larson is the finest example of the American style and viewpoint of literary investigative journalism. All of reality's details for future effects have been examined, pursued before reaching closure. The author's miracle lies in the fact that suspense and not boredom is maintained because of his stylistic appeal to our curiosity. This is a very detailed account of the building of the Chicago World's Fair in honor of the 400th anniversary of Columbus landing in the New World. While the author does do a good job at switching between the World's Fair and the story of H. When it comes to the World's Fair, the author describes a great amount of detail regarding the construction and all of the obstacle involved with constructing the fair. All in all, the book is an excellent book that goes into extraordinary detail of the 1893 Chicago World's Fair while switching to telling the story of H. The enormous effort to create and build the World's Fair and the dark tale of a psychopath. Imagining all the efforts that went into the fair in a time when communication and transportation was limited when compared with today, it is hard to believe the feats that they were able to achieve. Holmes that got double pleasure from learning about all the Chicago World Exposition history mixed into fascinating story of the 1893 World Columbian Exposition, the largest peaceful gathering in the world to date, intertwined with an American Jack the Ripper. And H. Larson is masterful in jumping between the lavish world of America's greatest architects and industrialists and the sick world of H. The author explains how many of the great builders of American cities came together to build World's Fair in a large and growing city. It is a story of how many new inventions and ideas were introduced to the country before the turn of the century. Frederick Law Olmsted, the landscape architect for the Chicago Fair, designed a master plan for the Stanford University grounds. First off, this is a very compelling and engrossing nonfiction book that reads as a novel. Similarly fascinating was reading about the people who attended the fair: Thomas Edison, Nikola Tesla, Helen Keller, Susan Bay. Also reading about the new inventions that were made specifically for the 1893 World's Fair, such as the Ferris wheel, the introduction of edibles like Cracker Jacks, juicy fruit, shredded wheat, etc. Henry Howard Holmes, who used the fair and his charms to lure victims, mainly young women and children, to their death. The fair itself was groundbreaking in every aspect, even in some for today's standards. It also provides a very colorful who is who of the epic and the lasting influence it had, especially in architecture. This is where both stories interact, although they could have well been two very good books. Yes, it is a great read, full of suspenseful moments and at times horrific details of the murders by H. Yes, it is a great book about the Columbus World's Fair that was built in Chicago in 1893 by America's greatest architects. The project at hand was the World's Fair, and the man behind it was Daniel Burnham. Are you one of those lucky few? Find out if you got what it takes. That was only the beginning of more to come, all in the shadow of the fair. an ancestor of Mudgetts, has gathered evidence that may eventually prove Mudgett and Jack the Ripper were one and the same. The Devil in the White City is hard to put down once you slug your way past the initial details on the selection and challenges with the World's Fair construction. Lynch shows what is really happening by taking his cameras and audience beneath the grass, giving a true close-up at the level of the earth and its bugs. You even get to see an ear and ear that has been obviously cut off, which has now become food for worms. In other words, what you see on the surface is not really how things are. You have to get under the covers to find the dirty reality of it all. You'll learn about the beautiful classic architecture designed for the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago, ultimately called the White City. You'll almost feel water coming off the wonderful lake with its more wonderful birds and the cooling effect that it all had on the fairgoers. But when you travel within just a few miles of that fair, you'll look under the covers and see the murders of H. The detective work was amazing, particularly due to the time frame, and the fact that the detective actually found bodies was remarkable. Given any other detective, the children would have remained buried forever, and so would have Mr. Holmes was surprised by the find, reading about it in the daily papers from his jail cell. With all of the forensics, DNA and tools at detectives' disposal today, it seems that some of the old school detectives were so much better. Then people's true natures might have been better revealed under the covers of the White City that soon would turn black. Once again, Eric Larson presents two compelling stories, interrelated and equally important tales of our history. All of the inventions that were introduced, even created for this World's Fair, were fascinating and relevant to this day. If you do not like long narratives that are rich in detail and short on dialogue, this may not be for you. The author holds back, bringing in events just at the right time, drawing in the reader who can't wait to get back to the book. The author provides enough detail to almost imagine living in Chicago at the time without spending three pages describing the color of a leaf. When Daniel Hudson Burns was asked to oversee the architecture and development of the World's Fair, Burns seen this as a way to really make a name for himself, working hard to get it right to create what would put Chicago on the map. An amazing attraction to celebrate the anniversary of Columbus' discovery of America that would draw people to it from all over the world. Holmes had a dark side that was easily masked by his piercing blue eyes, pleasant demeanor, fine style of dress, and Holmes just had an uncanny way with people. This well-written book reads like a smoothly flowing fiction book, but the fact is it is not fiction. Upon reading this book and taking a survey of our book club, no one in our group had heard of the missing people surrounding the fair or the man called Holmes. But before you set your creep factor on high, know that there is more to this book than the spooky mister. The first Cracker Jacks were at the fair also knew was Aunt Jemima pancakes, juicy fruit gum, Pabst Blue Ribbon beer, shredded wheat. Eric Larson has written this so well that it never feels heavy, with the Holmes dealings weaving in and out of the progress of the fair. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.